Hello everyone, welcome back again to Mufasu CAD channel with AutoCAD 3D modeling basic tutorial how to create a 3D headset. Okay, I will use a top view and first we can create circle in here with radius 266. Okay, we create a circle again, start from this point with radius 248. Okay, and I will create the line, start from this point to this point. We create circle, okay, start from this point into middle point in here. Okay, you can delete this object. And next, I will create line, okay, start from this point to the right here. You can move this line object to the bottom here, 80. Next, I will use trim command to cut this circle. Okay, we can create line start from this point to the bottom here, 175. And then you can use rotate command to rotate this line object. Start from this point with rotation angle 25 and enter. Okay. I will create line, okay, start from this point to the bottom, and you can use a trim command to cut this arch. Okay, you can select this object and delete. Next, I will use rotate command to rotate this object, start from this point with a rotation angle minus 25. Okay, you can select this object, right click, and then you can click hide object. Okay, I will change into left view. Okay, and next we can create circle. Okay, start from this point with the radius 60. Okay, you can move this circle object to the right here, 115. Next, we can create the line. Okay, start from this point to the bottom here, 35. And you can move this line object, start from middle point into this point. Okay, we can create line, start from this point to this point. And next, you can use circle command. Okay, we create circle with tangent radius. You can click this circle and this line object with the radius 80. Okay, and you can use trim command to cut this circle object, and we cut this line object. Okay, I will use mirror command to mirror these two object. Start from this point to the left and enter. Next, we can delete this line object, and you can use trim command to cut this circle. Okay, we can use join command to combine this all objects. And then I will create a circle object. Okay, start from center point in here. Okay, you can use M2P. Okay, I will click from this point to this point. And with diameter 90. Okay, you can orbit. And next, I will use extrude command to extrude this object with extrude distance 10. And you can use move command to move this object, okay, into this direction 15. Okay, but first I will active this enable dimension and pointer input. Okay, next we can use extrude command to extrude this circle into this direction about 17. And next I will use copy command to copy this object. Okay, start from this point into this point. Okay, you can use subtract command to subtract this object with this object. Okay. And next, I will create a circle object. Okay, we create circle start from center point in here with dimension, okay, diameter about 150, and you can move this object into this direction of 15, and we move again this object into this direction 18. Okay, we can copy this circle object into this direction 10. Next, I will change into X-ray view. Okay, you can press F7 to hide cut, and we can create circles start from center point in here into this point. I will select this object, right click, and then you can hide objects. Okay, you can use the loop command to loop this circle, okay, to this point and into here. Okay, enter, and then I will use settings, and we can use rules surface control, and you can click OK to apply. Okay, you can change into realistic view to view the object, and next we can end object isolation. Okay, we can change into top view, and in here I will create a rectangle object, okay, start from this point with dimension for length 35 and then for width 45. Okay, click at this point. You can use a fillet command, okay, with radius 3. We fillet in here, okay, fillet again in here, and the last in here. Okay, we can move this rectangle object start from this point. Okay, we can move into this point. Okay, you can change into 3D wireframe, and we can use a revolve command. You can tap revolve. We revolve this rectangle object start from a center point to drag it with angle 360 degree and enter. Okay, you can change into realistic view to view this object. Okay, now I will change face trees, okay, into 10 to look more smooth. Okay, you can use fillet command again, okay, with a radius 3. We fillet at this edge. Okay, I will fillet again in here and in here. Okay, sorry, I will union this object, and we fillet in here. Okay, we can fillet again. We can select this edge. Okay, we fillet in here, and then I will fillet in here. Okay, now you can move this object. Okay, I will change into X-ray, and we can move this arch start from this point. Okay, I will use M2P option. You can click in here and then click in here. Okay, next I will use offset edge. Okay, we offset this face with dimension -4 and -4. Enter. You can use extrude command, okay, to extrude this object with path. Okay, you can click this arch. Okay, now I will use fillet command. Okay, you can use fillet command. We fillet this edge, okay, with the loop option in here. Next, and okay, we fillet again. Okay, sorry, I will change into a top view, and next we can use rotate command to rotate this object start from this point with the rotation angle 25. And next I will use a mirror command to mirror this object start from this point to the top and enter. And you can use a union command to combine these two objects. I will give material into this object, but first I will move this object into coordinate 0.0. You can tap the S, okay, and inactive this enable dimension and enable pointer input. Okay, I will move this all object. Okay, start from this point with coordinate 0, 0, and enter. Okay, you can zoom and extend. Okay, I will change into top view, and we can create a plan surface object. Okay, start from this point to this point. We create a camera, start from this point into here. Okay, I will change into left view. And next, we can use a rotate command to rotate this object. Okay, start from this point. Okay, I will rotate into this point. Okay, you can change into camera one view. And next, we can add material into this 3D models. Okay, you can tap RMAT to open material browser. In here, I will use plastic material. Okay, you can click in plastic, and I will use smooth red for this material. You can select this part, and then we select this part. Okay, I will use smooth red. Okay, right click assign to selection. And for the other object, click this object. We attach smooth gray. Okay, you can search for smooth gray. Okay, you can right click assign to selection. Okay. Next, we can try to rendering this object. Okay, but first I will attach material in here. Okay, this for red, and this for smooth gray. Okay, I will edit this material. Okay, I will use a thin color, and you can change into red in here. Okay, okay. Next, we can try to rendering this 3D models. You can active full shadow. And next, I will use high render. You can set up resolution in here. Okay, I will active environment, and we can use a background with a solid and change into white color. Okay, and we can try to rendering this object. You can click here to render. Okay. Now we waiting for rendering until finish into 10 level. Okay, we finish rendering process, and enough today for AutoCAD 3D modeling basic tutorial how to create a 3D headset. If you have any question about this tutorial, you can comment below this video. And see you next time in another AutoCAD 3D modeling basic tutorial.